I'm not joking. Not the first cause. What will the child then take back feedback from it? My father doesn't know. My mother doesn't know. Right? How many of your kids have asked you such terrible questions? Give me a few examples of what they've asked you.
Sir, I'll ask you and tell me. Please tell me, they have not answered the question or you have not been with your kids when they were asking this question.
Answer also they can't understand. It's a very complex
nature. You break it down into something simple. Yes sir, you gave me, we'll tell later. What was that, I'll tell you later question your child asked.
When you can see the internet, you can, now you cannot see the internet.
This is next level of parenting. See internet, don't ask me. I don't have time for you. And I'm showing you, this is the pattern of parenting I've found. So I do research, even when you do research, you inculcate research in every activity you do. Curiosity is always there. Next level of parenting this is. Research, internet, go there. I don't have time, don't talk to me. Honest to your heart, how many have given these answers to your kids? Be very frank. Raise your hands. Raise your hands. Two. No, no, be frank. Raise high. Let there be some activity in your hands also. Blood flow now, you get flow. Yes. Was it an answer you could have easily explained, taken, had you taken 5 minutes of your time? No matter what, you would have easily been able to answer. Yeah, you probably need another 5-10 minutes of your work, of your time. You could have answered that question and the child will go back thinking. Now the child goes back, why bother asking, I'll go directly to internet. You detach emotionally from your kid. You give this answer at the age of 60, the child is grown up, doesn't matter. But if you give this age at the age of 35, when a kid is anywhere between 7 to 8 years old, or 3 to 8 years old, kid goes away. It will go to the person who will answer its question. How many of you got brilliant answers from your grandparents when your parents couldn't answer that same question? How were your grandparents able to do it and you were not able to do it? Or your parents were able to do it and you were not able to do it? Didn't they break down that complex problem to simple words to make that child understand? Then what is lacking in you? No sir, excessive knowledge is lacking in you. Ground reality, ours is bookish knowledge, theirs is application knowledge. You are able to reproduce textbook answers, they are able to give you live examples. There is a very nice way this was captured, I'll give you. How many of you seen the movie Swadesh? There is one question, when she goes to the, when these people go to the panchayat, no? When Shah Rukh Khan's, this one, foster caretaker takes her to the panchayat, introduce, he says, I build a satellite, I go to family satellite, everything.
What is satellite?
What is satellite? Karta kya hai? See the grandmother's answer. This is an ideal answer, that is how you have to approach it. She first gives an example. Tumne Chandrama dekha hai? Who has not seen movie? What's वो धरती के गोल घूमती रहती है. ऐसे ही ये भी गोल घूमता रहता है. जैसे वो रोशनी देती है, ये आपको दूसरे चीजों में मदद करती है. They know how to answer. Research. Conclusion has to be such simplified answers. When you are talking to a patient who is coming to you, please don't send him away sending medical jargons.
It is a humiliation on the profession of doctors. Tell him or her what problem you have in possibly the simplest one, either giving an example or an analogy, so that he or she goes back and says, yes, this is a preventive thing I can do in my life so that I don't get affected by it. Remember this at least once. Next time when you treat a patient or go to a patient or listen to his or her, give him an analogy or her an analogy of what it is. Doctors are supposed to listen to the patients, not order to the patients. Suppose, sorry to say this, but yes. Especially consultants who spend 2 minutes of their time and charge 600 rupees and don't even listen to the problem. I'll tell you why. There's nothing wrong in what they're doing. They have identified, I have seen so many patterns. The moment they see that they identify what is the pattern, they know what is the outcome. Hardly takes them 1 minute time. Do this, they'll get out. They have solved a problem. Their work is done. But the treatment is not done. Senior consultants, please take time. I know your time costs thousands of rupees. But yes, sometimes it helps build the life of a person. Especially ENT people, surgeons. I'll give a practical example. Cardiovascular surgeons, anesthesiologist people. What you are doing, when you say, I'm putting down a patient from anesthesia, what are you actually doing it? How many times can a person handle anesthesia? GA. Tell your patients what they are. At most respect you will have. They will come back to you no matter what. If you treat them, I'll come back. Treat them and come back again. This is a tractability test, not this test to figure out if it can be answered. Next is this one. Can you obtain a data set and define the measures to test the above solution? If you have yes, then you have a clearly defined problem to work on. No, can you think of any way to indirectly test the solution, or can you reframe the problem to fit the data? You can do this. So how do you do this? Some details. Just for the people who are there, na, interested people, that they want to know little more into the detail. Define the basic concept. Specify the input and output. And specify any preference or constraints. Okay? Let me see. This is not very... I'll come here. Now you define the problem, I said, right? The previous slide I said, how do you define your problem? Pick it somewhere over here. A good research problem. But you are not very convinced how to do it. Always go to the center of the box. Sit there and say, you want to make the problem harder or easier? Easy problem hard, hard problem easy. Move it from the challenges list up and down. If you want an impact, move it X and Y coordinates, move it. Then you find where is your comfort area. Then grow in that direction. Simple, applicable to anything that you do. I repeat, when you are finding a difficulty, go to the center of the graph where your level of challenges and impact usefulness is there. From there, depending upon your comfort, your challenge, move up and down, right or left to move to the point. This is called a problem solving loop. Graphically, last 10-15 minutes what we see on slides, minus all my work, identify the problem. Explore information, create ideas.
Okay.
Select the best idea. This is the most important part. This is where India is lacking. Build and test the idea. But we are ready to evaluate other person's results. We are lacking here. Strengthen this and your cycle is complete. Okay. Strengthen this. Because all this you will do, then you will go to America for treatment. shouldn't be that way. Build it here.
They are also completely delayed.
Good. That is because that solution is coming now. And why?
Here delay is more, here faster.
No. Their money is more.
Not delay.
The
angiogram.
Money
is time. Yeah,
angiogram.
Both are there. First money, sir.
First money is.
Not money.
Sir, if you have 5 lakh rupees,
UK,
you will do
surgery. You have big waiting list, but other patient is there. Huh. So they will come here and get it done.
Correct. What is the difference between them and us?
No.
They are having little litigation than them. They are having more litigations. That's why doctors are taking much time and eat and everything. They are stealing their
I will put it in a different way. I am a research guy, right? Let me not go into argument. We have scaled enough. Our sample sizes are higher. For our 130 crores population, our sample sizes are higher. So we have scaled our system to work for higher population. We can handle more throughput. Theirs cannot. Because theirs is work for Ireland population only. That is why the delay. It is still coming there. Population numbers is where you have to work. Yes sir, money you say, facilities you say. Why the throughput is less? Because they can handle only so many. And they have constrained it within a legal system saying more litigation. No. We can handle hundreds and thousands of people more here.
Our experience is more.
Arvind Eye Care. What are the number of cataract surgeries Arvind Eye Care can do?
He work more.
He does more surgeries in one day than entire country does in 1 year or 1 month. Or entire one country does in 1 day. Whatever reference you take. Because he has scaled it up to that level. Everything is optimized. Your surgeon will hardly spend 3 to 5 minutes on you. He will be that optimist. He will do 60 surgeries per day, typically, rough number. Every alternate day. Surgery one day, treatment the other day, OPD the other day. Because that person, that doctor, identified what levels you have issues. Take care of the issues before you come to the OT itself. Once you come to the OT, you should be done, solved and get out of it. Similarly with angiogram, will happen in shortly. Something of that nature will come. Now, this is for the people who are actually doing research. What is the shortcut? How do you find, sir? All said and done. You have told us how to find a problem, method to find a problem, where to go, what to do. But still I don't know where to start. Go to the latest paper in your work. In that, after the work section, or find the latest thesis, there is a mandatory chapter called Future Work and Directions. Find that chapter. You already have some problems defined for it. Subject them to NTE test and then modify and make your problems out. So what is the turnout of how many MDS students pass out every year? MDS. Students, how many MDS students pass out every year? Or what is your intake and what is your output?
24 per year.
24 per year, yeah. But 24 go out of the same batch?
Almost.
That's a good management answer. See, this is how you interpret the answer. It is not the final answer. Interpretation is there. Some polish here, but we extract the raw data from other side. Almost means what, 20 out of 22 or 15 out of 22. So
it is still the almost. Won't be the same. That's why the interpretation should be there. Every year it won't be the same. That's
right. That is called time constraint. What are constraints they go through?
According to the question, the answer will come.
Exactly. So, sir is getting angry here. He is feeling offended. Don't, sir. It is math, simple numbers only. End of the day, a statistician will come and ask how many input, how many output. Which year, which input. They are doing auditing, right? NBA audits or NIA audits. I think the hospital has to do audits. When you undergo the audits, these are the questions they will simply ask. There your emotion will not come into play, they will simply say math. So don't put emotion into math. It is harmful. Okay? So find the nearest paper where you get. So that's where you find. So when you have 24 outputs, you will have 24 theses coming out. Each 24 theses will have so many defined future research problems. Go to the 24 research chapters. Find already problems.
like that, go 1 year back, 48, 1 year back, 72, 1 year back, 96. 4 years, you have got nearly 100 problems to sit and decide for 24 people. Each person will have 4 problems to tackle. Unless the future batch is taken over. The work is half solved already. Don't build new things. Try and do the work. Carry over the new things, you will actually do much more better impact. Because if you show that, if you remember that the graph I showed, the maximum activity is here on top, but the good results are below here. These results are your 24 theses. You do that, you can jump from here to there directly. You don't have to come from scratch. Continue the work. At half the effort, you will get double their benefit. There again, business only. This is knowledge business. Conversion is faster. And you will have the benefit of a person, previous person's full recorded data with you. Want to clarify doubts? Quickly go see. You have done already so much research, so much interpretation, and you would have conveyed it to your consultant also. Talk to them. Your work is nearly done. The turnaround time will be faster. Time to do better research will be more. Generally, time is spent in finding out the problem. Here, you have nearly got half the problem. Instead of 6 months, spend about 2 months to solve your problem. You have got additional 4 solid months to work on it, apart from the regular 6 months. This is for the management people who are thinking about it, right? How do you drive innovation? See the current one and take it forward. Don't start afresh. See that you take it to an end and see that yes, if it is beyond an end or needs a huge impact, only then do something. Otherwise, continue it forward. Read such research papers in detail. Track down background papers to increase your understanding. That's why I said 4 years. Brainstorm the ideas of the extending the work. Start with the ideas mentioned in the future part. Systematically question the solidness of the paper. Have the authors answered all the questions? Can you think of questions that aren't answered in that work? Is there a better formulation of the same problem? Is there a better method to solve the same problem? Is the evaluation solid? If not, all of these, pick one new idea and work on it. Generally, you will not have to come here. First point only, you will get a lot more ideas. This is a lot more management oriented, but sure as sure. This is a lot mostly math. Hypothesis about methods, test, how do you typical, then carefully study the literature to figure out where you can make a new contribution. Any MBA grads here? Not possible, right? Yes, sir, great. In MBA, they would have asked you to, if you have studied MBA, right? The moment you have a core problem, they will say there are 6 or 7 vectors which are causing that problem. Then they ask you to do a spider web diagram. I don't know if you know that. Basically, how much effort is already put, how much effort is lacking, and join those points to find a region of influence. For example, just to make you picturize, think you have a pizza, okay? Pizza is cut into 6 sectors, 6 areas of work. The amount of work done will be to the center of the pizza. The leftover work is outside. Only cut those portions out. So leftover work is where you can focus. You can see 2 aspects there. Monetary aspects or social aspects or impact aspects. You can pick as you go outside. So you need to draw a map like that. So once you draw a map, you will clearly know there is a work that you have not focused. You can quickly focus. Or you can do the other side. If it was not done, why was it not done? Is there a reason it was not done? Was it not fetching results? Or there is a definitive change happening there? Why was it not worked upon? So you will get open-ended ideas there. You can close them later. It is easier. When you take a thesis, right, do that. So it won't take you about not even 10-15 days of time. It's just like some literature work, you'll actually close. From there on, you can actually interpolate or extrapolate the reason and find out what all you can do. How much innovation you can go through, how much work you can go through. Hopes are you getting the visual picture of it. The more specialized the hypothesis, the more likely it is due. But a narrow hypothesis has a lower impact than a general one. I can't be medical is the best example for this.
special hypothesis. Specialized hypothesis is like a specialized specialization that you go forward. Right from MBBS, you go specialized, you narrow down to a very specific part of a human body that you would like to treat in depth. But you will have a lower impact in many cases. Now, in some cases, you might be the best solution that a person will get. You will give the best out of the solution. But sometimes, you will give a solution which may be outside the sphere of exact solution. It will be around it, but not the exact. Like that, your research problem, the moment it goes specialized, right, the focus that will be very small. You will have a very narrow focus, and your application will not be able to move it quickly. So try to have a very broad spectrum of information, but narrow down, like a funnel. But see that you can place this funnel in different places and still get the same output. Take the same funnel, put it in one area, move the same funnel, put it in another area. Are you getting an output? See that you mold your research in that way, so that you can quickly apply in multiple areas. But avoid overgeneralization. Okay. That is something that you have to be a little careful about. Then you again tune it back. Go back to the cycle and see. Do you want further tuning or you just want to stay where you are? This is again, we have already spoken about most of these. Clearly define the hypothesis, design the right experiments, analyze the results. Unless you have got a complete understanding, always attempt to formulate a further hypothesis to achieve a better understanding of the problem. Okay, this is just details of that same thing. There is conditions that we say, right? Some are necessary conditions, some are supplementary conditions, some are optional conditions. So when you define a problem, see that you include all possible necessary conditions. Then you keep, as you narrow down, your optional and supplementary will keep up. So this necessary condition is your top of your funnel. Wherever you want, you keep the top, it has to be necessary only. But depending upon what supplementary condition you put, the result will filter out in that area. And where additional one is like your specialization, you move. So it's like a, you can call it like a three level branch of a solution. First level is a necessary condition, it's like a big umbrella. Below it, you will put additional umbrella and say, within this umbrella, I will solve these problems. Within that bigger umbrella, smaller umbrella, I will solve these problems. But you should be able to have a still big umbrella fully under control. So that is your necessary condition, broad range of research. Design the right experiments. Like I said, we are missing the design portion, testing portion. Let us try and design them to test all of these. Okay, the data, a flawed experiment design is a common cause of rejection of most papers. When a paper gets rejected, top reason is the experiment designed to test the hypothesis was not sufficient.